So now that we know that a cache is a small memory inside our processor where we are trying to find the data before we go to the main memory, let's take some time and recap what we need out of a cache. We need it to be fast, which means it has to be small. Because it's small, not everything will fit. There will be a lot of memory locations that we do not have room for in our cache. So when a processor wants to access some memory, we can have a cache hit, which occurs when we find what we are looking for in the cache. The memory location we are interested in was already brought from the memory to the cache before, so now we are accessing it and we can just find it in the cache and the access is then very quick. So this is what we want. We want fast accesses for most of our memory accesses. And that happens when we have a lot of cache hits. But because the cache is very small and not everything fits in it, we can also have a cache miss. This happens when what we're looking for is not in the cache, and in that case we have to access the slow memory. When we have a cache miss, we want to copy this location to the cache so that next time we access it, and hopefully we will because of locality, we will have a cache hit. So it is necessary to have cache misses because that's how we really bring stuff into the cache in order to have hits. The more locality we have, the more cache hits we will have and the fewer cache misses, because one miss will bring the data into the cache and then hopefully we will use it many, many times. When we have a cache miss, that is slow, that access is going to take some time, but that should happen very rarely. Most of the time when we need something, we find it in the cache. Or at least we hope to do that, and we want to design our caches so that that's how it works.